This video explains in detail the nuances of the neuromuscular junction.
Skeletal muscle cells contract as a result of impulses from motor neurons. The place where a motor neuron stimulates a muscle cell is called a neuromuscular junction. Skeletal muscle cells are electrically insulated from each other by endomysium. In order for skeletal muscle cells to contract, each cell must be stimulated by a process of a motor neuron. Each motor neuron is a single nerve cell extending from the brain or spinal cord to the muscle, where it can stimulate several muscle cells. The axon is the elongated process of the nerve cell that carries impulses to the muscle. The neuromuscular junction is the place where the terminal portion of a motor neuron axon meets the muscle cell membrane. Click the neuromuscular junction to see it in an expanded view.
So remember we called a process the sticky outy part of a bone? Axons are part of nerves that are processes. They're sticky outy parts of the nerve. Now understand this is one nerve cell, huge, and it's branched like a tree. And each of those little branches have branches. Branches have branches. Weird, but okay. And so each of those little branches locks onto one of these different muscle cells. Remember, each one of these is one of those straws. And so one neuron may connect to two or three different muscle fibers or two or three different muscle straws. So this is the same as this image that we saw, that we labeled earlier. And we talked about how if you chop off one through physical therapy, you can get the axon to grow and connect to other nerve cells, or to connect to other muscle cells.
Now let's take a closer look at a neuromuscular junction. The swollen distal end of the motor neuron axon is called the axon terminal. Within the axon terminal are synaptic vesicles containing the neurotransmitter acetylcholine.
Okay, I say acetylcholine, they say acetylcholine. I'm pretty sure that's just a robot voice pronouncing that for you. But the yellow thing we've already labeled is the axon, and this is simply the end of the axon or the axon terminal. What kind of axon? What kind of nerve it is? What kind of nerve is it? It is a neuron. What type of neuron? It is a motor neuron, meaning that it sends a signal from your spinal cord to the muscle cell. It is designed to carry a signal that's going to stimulate motion.
Notice that at the neuromuscular junction, the motor neuron and the sarcolemma of the muscle cell do not actually touch. The synaptic cleft is the space between the axon terminal and a folded region of the sarcolemma called the motor end plate.
All right, so we call the synaptic cleft the synapse, same difference. Motor end plate, this is just the sarcolemma of the muscle cell. But as I mentioned, it's very, very folded. What does that extra folding provide? Extra surface area.
Highlighted here in red. Recall that the sarcolemma is the general name for the muscle cell membrane. The T-tubules are invaginations of the sarcolemma penetrating deep into the interior of the cell. The terminal cisternae are specialized regions of the sarcoplasmic reticulum that serve as reservoirs of calcium ions, shown here as red dots. Portions of the sarcoplasmic reticulum have been removed here in order to see the underlying structures. The sarcomere is the contractile unit of the muscle cell that extends from one Z-line to the next.
All right, remember sarcolemma, Z-line to Z-line. Underneath, just kidding, sarcomere, Z-line to Z-line. The sarcolemma is the cell membrane. Underneath that cell membrane, you have sarcoplasmic reticulum. So this network of reticulum would be covering all of this, much like you see over here. The terminal cisternae, terminal simply means end, is the end of that sarcoplasmic reticulum. What is a cisternae? Well, cisternae refers to the word cistern. Cisterns are typically used for storing items like water. In the olden days, you would have cisterns full of water. We didn't have electricity. We didn't have ways to regularly get rain. So we would either collect the water in the cistern, or we would have a windmill that would use wind energy to pump water from below the surface and store it in a cistern. Terminal cisternae is just the end of the sarcoplasm where calcium ions are stored. And in this case, the calcium ions are red dots. You can see the thin actin fibers. You can see the thick myosin fibers. So you've got neuron and muscle.
The plus and minus signs on the axon terminal, sarcolemma, and T-tubules indicate a polarized condition called the resting membrane potential. Although plus and minus signs are not shown on the motor end plate, it is also polarized.
All right, so by polarized,
here's an overview on the activity.
Would you just chill? Polarized simply means it's charged. There's a charge, a difference in charge on the membrane. In this case, it's positive on the outside, negative on the inside. So you would see a positive here in the synapse and a negative charge on the inside. Same thing here, negative charge on the inside, positive on the outside. So that would be pony, P-O-N-I, positive on the outside, negative on the inside.
That occurs at the neuromuscular junction. An action potential arriving at the axon terminal triggers the release of a neurotransmitter, acetylcholine, resulting in the depolarization of the motor end plate. This depolarization triggers an action potential that propagates along the sarcolemma and down the T-tubules, causing contraction of the sarcomeres. On the next several pages, we will look at this process in more detail. To see the activity at the neuromuscular junction as a continuous process, click the motor neuron.
Okay, recall here the muscle and the nerve are at rest. The nerve and the muscle are polarized. The whole situation of the membrane is pony. Positive on the outside, negative on the inside. Now, this is not textbook worthy. Don't go to college and try to impress your professors by calling it pony. This is just my way of remembering it from my little brain, what the resting membrane potential is. Yeah, I got it. Okay.